my name is Regret. I'm pretty sure we have met. Every single day of your life, I'm the whisper inside, won't let you forget. Hello, my name is Dick Beat. I know you recognize me. Just when you think you can win, I drag you right back down again till you've lost all belief. Oh, these are the voices. Oh, these are the lies. And I have believed them for the very last time. Hello, my name is Child of the One True King. I've been saved, I've been changed, I have been set free. Amazing grace, the song I sing. Hello, my name is Child of the One True King. By all the wreckage behind, the one who makes all things new has proven it's true. Take a look at my life. Hello, my name is Child of the One True King. I've been saved, I've been changed, I have been set free. Amazing grace, the song I sing. Hello, my name is Child of the One True King. What love, what love the Father has lavished upon us, that we should be called His children. I am a child of the One True King. What love the Father has lavished upon us, that we should be called His children. Hello, my name is Child of the One True King. I have been set free. Amazing grace, the song I sing. Hello, my name is Child of the One True King. I am a child of the One True King. I am a child of the One True King. I am a child of the One True King. I am a child of the One True King. Hallelujah. Put my life down at your feet. You're the only one I need. Turn to you and you are always there. Troubled times is you are sick. I put your first, that's all I need. I humble all I am, all to you. One way, Jesus, you're the only one that I could live for. How and everywhere, there is the bond so deep within me. You will never ever change. Yesterday, today, the same. Forever here, forever is the end. One way, Jesus, you're the only one that I could live for. One way, Jesus, you're the only one that I could live for. One way, Jesus. own way. Jesus, you're the only one that I could live for. One way. Jesus, you're the only one that I could live for. One way. Jesus, you're the only one that I could live for.
One way. Jesus, thank you,
when darkness tries to roar above my bones, when sorrow comes to steal the joy I own, when brokenness and pain is all I know, I won't be shaken, no, I won't be shaken. My fear doesn't stand a chance when I stand in your love. My fear doesn't stand a chance when I stand in your love. My fear doesn't stand a chance when I stand in your love. Shame no longer has a place to hide. I am not a captive to the lies. I'm not afraid to leave my past behind. I won't be shaken. No, I won't be shaken. My fear doesn't stand a chance when I stand in your love. My fear doesn't stand a chance when I stand in your love. My fear doesn't stand a chance when I stand in your love. There's power that can break every chain. This power that can empty out a grave. This resurrection power that can save. This power in your name. Power in your, there's power. Doesn't stand a chance when I stand in your love. My fear doesn't stand a chance when I stand in your love. My fear doesn't stand a chance when I stand in your love. Doesn't stand a chance when I stand in your love. My fear doesn't stand a chance when I stand in your love. My fear doesn't stand a chance when I stand in your love. land. You set my feet upon the rock. Now I know Father, thank you so much. Thank you for loving us and guiding us. And thank you that you lead us, lead our lives. Father God, we want to pray, we want to ask you that show us your vision, your will for us. All of us follow your will. Live in this world as a witness of Jesus Christ, because we are your children, we are Christians, we are believers, we are your chosen people. Father God, we confess that with songs, Jesus is only our way. We love you. We never afraid, fear. When we face the difficulties, because you are my Savior, you are my Master, and Holy Spirit, you always help us. Yeah, all our prayer that we need something, so we ask you, oh, Father God, now, in this moment, this time, we just give everything to you, what you need. Yes, you don't need anything because you are perfect. Father God, we want to give you something what you want for us. Father God, now we listen to your message. Please let us know that your true message in this time, in this moment. Holy Spirit, come in this place, come in each and everyone. So everyone accept this word, what you say to us right now, in this place. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for always being with us. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated.
Today's scripture reading comes from the book of Ruth, chapter 3, verses 7 to 15. When Boaz had finished eating and drinking and was in good spirits, he went over to lie down at the far end of the grain pile. Ruth approached quietly, uncovered his feet, and lay down. In the middle of the night, something startled the man. He turned, and there was a woman lying at his feet. "Who are you?" he asked. "I am your servant Ruth," she said. "Spread the corner of your garment over me, since you are a guardian redeemer of our family." "The Lord bless you, my daughter," he replied. "This kindness is greater than that which you showed earlier. You have not run after the younger men, whether rich or poor. And now, my daughter, don't be afraid. I will do for you all you ask. All the people of my town know that you are a woman of noble character. Although it is true that I am a guardian redeemer of your family, there is another who is more closely related than I. Stay here for the night, and in the morning, if he wants to do his duty as your guardian redeemer, good. Let him redeem you. But if he is not willing, as surely as the Lord lives, I will do it. Lie here until morning." So she lay at his feet until morning, but got up before anyone could be recognized. And he said, "No one must know that a woman came to the threshing floor." He also said, "Bring me the shawl you are wearing and hold it out." When she did so, he poured into it 6 measures of barley and placed the bundle on her. Then he went back to town.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Oops. Hallelujah. 하늘 hallelujah. Amen. Yeah. Good to see you, Millie. Yeah, how are you? Good. Yeah. May the grace and peace of the Lord be with you all who worship with us today. Next slide, please. Do you know this theory? Yeah. I want to talk about this. Yeah, he's a psychologist. Maslow divides human needs into these 5 steps. Yeah. So the first is physiological needs. It's a basic need to sustain human life. I think you guys may understand, may heard about these 5 needs. The second is a safety needs. It is a need to maintain safety and protection away from danger.
Yeah, reason this is also called an economic need. The third one, third is love and belonging needs. Since humans are social beings, right? A human have a desire to belong to a group and a desire to be accepted by the group. This appears to be an interest in affection, friendship, acceptance, and belonging. The fourth one is the desire for self-esteem, esteem needs. It is a desire to enjoy honor or power, bless you. Power as a member of an affiliated organization. Self-esteem, autonomy, and achievement are internal factors, and status, recognition, and being the object of interest are external factors. The fifth one is self-actualization needs. It is the highest level of desire to fully demonstrate one's talent and potential to achieve everything one can achieve. It includes the desire for growth and self-completion. So what do you think? Do you agree with him? Yeah? Aren't you curious why I'm telling you the theory of needs? It's not a psychological class. Yeah. It can be said that humans live to satisfy their needs. Do you agree with me? Yeah. Yeah, you eat food when you're hungry, right? There's a psychological needs. Yeah, you want to satisfy that. Yeah, when you're sleepy, you go to bed. But I'm not telling you that you're sleepy in this time. Anyway, the reason why we wear masks and vaccinate, because we want to save, right? In the COVID-19 pandemic. How would you feel if you were alienated from your friends? And would you mind if you're not recognized at work and you don't get promoted? What if you have a dream, vision that you want and it gets frustrating? Think about it. You will try to meet your needs, right? According to what criteria and how we meet the needs we want is what kind of life we live. I'm going to talk about this with you through this message, through today's text. So I would like to share the blessing of God with you under the title, Keep Your Dignity. What does dignity mean? In what situation do we use this term, dignity? Dignity means the state of quality of being worthy of honor or respect. So we use the word dignity for humans, right? Not animals, not things. Whether you admit it or not, many people live our life or pursuing materials to make a lot of money. And you say that, oh, you're dignity to people who do everything they can to make money. Can you say that a person who commits crimes and scams and even kills to get more money has dignity? No, we didn't say that. You can figure out with common sense who to use this word for. Then, do you think the word dignity suits Boaz and Ruth in today's text? I want to talk about Ruth. Ruth is a poor foreign woman, right? She's a widow, right? She can make a living only by picking up grains from fields. And Ruth lives life to meet the needs of the lowest level of Maslow's needs, the physiological needs. If you are Ruth, would you be able to reveal to others you are a dignified woman? Yeah, today's text, what we read, Ruth is even trying to sleep with a rich man, right? Does dignity make sense to a woman like this? Boaz tells Ruth like this, verse 10 and 11, please.
The Lord bless you, my daughter, he replied. This kindness is greater than that which you showed earlier. You have not run after the younger men, whether rich or poor. And now, my daughter, don't be afraid. I will do for you all you ask. All the people of my town know that you are a woman of noble character.
What he said, you are a woman of a noble character. You are a woman of a noble character. Yeah, Proverbs chapter 31, verse 10 to 31, records about a woman, wife, of a noble character. I don't want to read everything, so yeah, verse 10, please.
A wife of noble character who can find. She is worth far more than rubies.
But the Bible says she is worth more than rubies. It's precious, precious. A woman, a wife of noble character does not mean that, oh, she's a beautiful, she's a cute. No. The Bible is talking about the value of this woman. Ruth, she has lived the life of a dignified and wise woman, even though she's a poor foreigner and make a living by picking up grain. Not only Boaz, but also Bethlehem people. All people know that Ruth is a woman of a noble character. I want to talk about Boaz. Book of Ruth, chapter 2, referred to Boaz as a man of standing. Man of standing. The Bible, you can figure out that Boaz is not only rich, but also he's a socially reputable person who is respected by people. So in other words, that he is a dignified person. Maybe you know that the former New York governor, Cuomo? Yeah, his brother is a CNN anchor. Yeah, the governor of New York resigned in August last year. Why he resigned that? Yeah, he has some problem, a sexual harassment scandal. But we don't know much about him. But considering his social position as a governor, he can be said to be respected and honored by people, right? But we don't know about them. His personal life was completely different. But I want to tell you the Boaz. He fell asleep drunk, right? Without his knowing, a young woman, Ruth, was lying on a blanket with him, but Boaz, he didn't touch Ruth. He didn't do that. Later, he was considerate of Ruth. Verse 13 to 15, please.
Stay here for the night, and in the morning, if he wants to do his duty as your guardian redeemer, good, let him redeem you. But if he is not willing, as surely as the Lord lives, I will do it. Lie here until morning. So she lay at his feet until morning, but got up before anyone could be recognized, and he said, no one must know that a woman came to the threshing floor. He also said, bring me your shawl you are wearing and hold it out. So she did. When she did so, he poured into his 6 measures of barley and placed the bundle on her. Then he went back to town.
Please go back to verse 13. Yeah. What he said. As surely as the Lord lives, I will do it. Yeah, Boaz even swore before God that he would take responsibility for Ruth. So he made that, oh, I swore before God, so it's okay, I take care of her. It's okay to have a physical relationship with her. Yeah, he made that. I'm not sure that, but Boaz, he didn't do that. He didn't touch her. He just concentrated on Ruth. Yeah, sisters, Boaz is a really cool and decent guy, right? Yeah. He's a man of a dignity who knows how to value and care for a woman. I hope that you meet a man of this character, like Ruth, like Boaz. I think Ruth and Boaz, both they had kept dignity as those who believe in God. They know how to respect each other because they are in awe of God. They are not using each other for their own needs, own desire, but they are showing us dignity as people with faith in God. Yes, keep your dignity. Have some dignity. I want to talk about Jesus. What dignity does Jesus, we believe in, have? Everyone is equal. All people is equal. Am I right? Black and white, Asian and Muslim, all people are equal. Therefore, anyone is dignified as a human being, right? But there was discrimination even now and at the time of Jesus. The socially marginalized people, orphans and widows, tax collectors and prostitutes and disabled people, Jesus became their friend. Jesus did not discriminate against them. Do you know what happened to Jesus when he was captured? After the Last Supper with his disciples, Jesus prayed at the Mountain of Olives. At the end of the prayer, around midnight on Friday, Judas Iscariot came with soldiers to arrest Jesus. At the time, all disciples, everyone left Jesus. They ran away. So one of them was like this. Book of Mark, chapter 14, 15:1 and 52, please.
A young man wearing nothing but a linen garment was following Jesus. When they seized him, he fled naked, leaving his garment behind.
Oh my goodness. And Simon Peter. Peter had a sword and pulled it out. He struck the high priest's slave and cut off his right ear. The slave's name was Marcus. But Jesus did not resist. Later, he healed his ear. And Jesus said to Peter like this, Matthew 26, verse 52, and Luke 22, and verse 51, please.
Put your sword back in its place, Jesus said to him, for all who draw the sword will die by the sword. But Jesus answered, no more of this. And he touched the man's ear and healed him.
Amen. Jesus, our Savior, he showed his dignity even in the urgent moment of being captured. Listen, Jesus blamed no one when he was tried, when he received ridiculous judgment were made, when soldiers mocked, when soldiers make fun of him. When he was tortured, when he carried the cross, when he was crucified, and until the moment he died. Even Jesus prayed like this for those who laughed at him and mocked him. Luke 23, verse 34.
Jesus said, Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing. And they divided up his clothes by casting lots.
Father, forgive them. Forgive them. For they do not know what they are doing. It's really important. They don't know. They don't know. But we knew, right? Yes, he's our Savior. He's Jesus Christ. We must keep our dignity as believers under any circumstances. Even in difficulties, in unbearable moments of pain, even in the face of death, we keep our dignity. Pastor Gabe, I think I'm going to die because I'm having a hard time, but is it important to keep my dignity in these situations? It's only possible for Jesus. Do you think like that? You knew that. There are still people who are martyred and tortured for not denying Jesus Christ in 2022. Think about Christians in Muslim countries. Think about people who turned from Muslim to Christianity. Think about underground churches in China and North Korea. Who threatens you that you believe in Jesus? No. As I have said many times to you guys, we live our life, our faith, so comfortably and safely. Pray. Pray for the suffering Christians. Have dignity. Keep dignity as a Christian and as a children of God. Amen? Yeah, we need that. And humans often cross in front of their primal needs. What is the fundamental needs, desire to shake your faith, shake your life? What are the needs that hinder you from keeping your dignity as a Christian? Money? Sexual? Or others? There are countless Christians in prison too. Yeah, many of the inmates have accepted Jesus Christ as a Savior in prison and jail. However, despite believing in Jesus, many people have committed crimes. Among the pastors, among the elders, among the deacons, among the believers, there are many who did wrong. In front of others, there are people who act like classy, dignity people in public, but there are people who act without dignity when they are in private or alone. But keep that in mind. God is watching you. God is watching me. God is watching us. Yeah, we are precious children of God. Don't forget. When you have any needs, please think again about whether they are really necessary for you. And put it down and pray. Put it down and pray. As you all keep your dignity as Christians, reveal your value to other peoples. From March 2nd to April 16th, it is Lent. Next slide, please. Prayer, fasting, giving. Yeah, we're watching the short video this morning. And Alicia, someone explained and told to kids about that. Let's all practice living a dignified life of children of God, saints, during Lent together. Next slide, please. We prayed last year, yeah. from April 2nd to May 1st, it's a Ramadan period. Yeah. I ordered the books, the prayer guide already. I will give it to you later. Let's express our dignity as a prayer for Muslims during Ramadan season. Let's all make people know that you are a Christian of dignity, both in God's eyes and in others' eyes. The Holy Spirit will help you to not worry. Keep your dignity. This is God's will to you and me. Let's sing one song and all pray together. We are Christian. We are children of God. But think about your life. Look back your lives. Have some dignity in Jesus Christ. And keep your dignity in any circumstances. We are children of God. And many thoughts come and many temptations come to you. and you can overcome. Keep your dignity in Jesus Christ. You can do that. We can do that. Because Holy Spirit help you. He helping you in this moment, in your future. Do not worry about that. And keep praying and show your faith to others. Help, give, pray. Do you have any problems? Put it down and pray. Keep praying. Father God, thank you so much. Thank you for everything. Thank you for your love. Jesus, thank you for your sacrifice. Father God, let the season start. And Ramadan is coming. And we know that what is our next step? Yes, we must train, grow up, not just follow our desire and needs. But many people follow that their own dreams. Oh, Father God, we are your children. We are chosen people. So we are different. Yeah, all people are equal, but we are different. We have faith in you. So we must follow your will. We live in this world, not follow our desire. We just keep our dignity. What Jesus, you showed us. Father God, we want to pray that for people who are in the suffering. Father, in Lent season, we want to pray for them. We help them, give something to them. Jesus, you never blame to others, even though you prayed, said, Father, please forgive them. Yes, Father God, please allow that this heart and mind to us, that someone tried to make fun of us and or mark us or make bad thing give to us, we just ignore that and forgive them, especially in this season, Lent season. So we all practiced and knowing and trained and developed and grown up with the decisions that we more follow and like what Jesus showed us. And Father God, Ramadan is coming. We want to pray for Muslim world, not only for this season. Father God, they really don't know who is Jesus Christ. They just know that, recognize that Jesus is the one of the prophet, one of the teachers. They not accept that Jesus is Son of God. But we knew that. So we just keep praying for them. And especially pray that a Muslim who's suffering right now, we not only pray for them, they believe in Jesus Christ, accept Jesus is Son of God, and turn to you, not only for that. We also pray that people who are in suffering in their countries, Father God, please give a heart and mind your love. So Father God, please let all of us pray for them and pray the people, even though who harm us. Because you didn't blame. You forgive them. Yes, we need this heart. Holy Spirit, please help us. Your power and strength and forgive anyone. Father God, please heal all our members' heart. So everyone healed with the Holy Spirit. And every day, live in this world with joy. Father God, we pray that who needs a physical problems or mental problem and financial problems, a problem with others, please solve this problem. And all of us live every day with you. Father God, we give offering to you, Lord. Please receive this offering and receive our heart and mind and our lives. So please use this offering. Please use us for your kingdom and glory. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for always being with us. May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and love Almighty God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all God's children from now and forevermore. Amen. God loves you so much. You are never alone. You are a child of God. God bless you. See you next week.